The sad part was of their emigration is that they only could afford to take three of their six children with them, who was Kevin, an older brother, and baby Kathleen, who was a sister of Margaret's. And they left the other three children here with their uncle, Matthew O'Rourke. It's been said they left Tully in an ass with creels, and that took them to where they could catch the boat. We're not very sure whether it was Sligo, Drogheda, Cork, or where. We're not very sure. It was a sad part in leaving their other three children, their older three children, but they had always promised they'd come back and get them to America and the family be reunited at one time. It took them 3 months when they got the boat to get to Baltimore. There was a lot of deaths on a rough voyage. But when they got to America, which they had reached was Chesapeake Bay, they got work and things were going well for them. And they were seeing their way that they'd be able to send money back to home to send their children over when yellow fever struck. Margaret's parents, both William and Margaret, died. The little baby, Kathleen, died, and her brother, Kevin, disappeared. So Margaret was alone. But a lady, she was a Mrs. Richards, that knew Margaret while they were travelling, took her in. She didn't take her in now to educate her. She took her in so that Margaret could work and earn her keep. So Margaret was with Mrs. Richards for, I don't know to what age, till she was old enough to go out in the world, which would have been young at that time too. And she went out to work and she met her husband, who was Charles Hawhery. He had not very good health. I'm not sure whether it was TB he had or what, but it was suggested that they go to live beside the water. So they decided to move from Baltimore down to New Orleans. There they had their little daughter, Frances. But his health wasn't improving and it was suggested he take an ocean voyage. So he went back to Cork, to where he was originally from. But sadly he passed away when he was in Cork. Very shortly afterwards, baby Frances died. So Margaret was left alone again for her second time at the age of 23. And it was told that it was an Irish priest buried Frances. All Margaret wanted to do was look after children. So he took her down to the orphanage that was close by, and she went in there and she slept in the dormitory with the orphans. And Margaret only was happy to work and look after the children.